fourth. They move on to 45 points and to within a point of second place, Manchester United and Leicester, who both played today, as I mentioned. Spurs stay ninth on 36 points. They're nine off the top four. They've got a game in hand on the Hammers. It was nervy in the end, wasn't it, from your former side? But they held out, though, Alan.
Yeah, and I think, you know, look at the first 50 minutes. You know, they scored their two goals and they looked quite comfortable. But then the change in... changing personality and mentality of Spurs by bringing Bale on,
yeah,
I think changed the whole complexion of the second half.
Why didn't they play like that in the first half, Tim?
Well, Jose, be asking the same thing, asking the same question, but there's more intent. But also, you've got a player like... there's the first goal. Look, what a delivery that is from Jarrod Bowen. Poor defending. Lucas Moura leaves Funchal, distracts Dier, leaves a gaping hole there, and Antonio does what he does best against Tottenham. But Jesse Lingard here, he just thrusts forward. For now, he's going to take it there and he just leaves it. If he went and touched it, he would have been in an offside position. Jesse's been brilliant. It's a fantastic strike, gives them 2-0 lead.
And this gave Spurs hope, didn't it, Alan?
Well, it did. And then the game just turned round.
Yeah.
It was all Spurs. I think Gareth Bale showed us what he's about. Is that Harry Kane? Is it Declan Rice? Yeah. I mean, that is a match-winning save, isn't it? It's a great bit of defending. Then Gareth Bale hits the bar. They've hit the bar a couple of times. A bit too late for Spurs, wasn't it?
Yeah, they got lucky at the end as well.
I think
Fabianski is such a fabulous goalkeeper, but he rode his luck on this occasion. When it comes out to Son, it just ricochets over the top of his head. Sanchez can't touch it in and they clear their lines. But you have to give Moisey credit. He's done brilliantly at this football club. And when you can't, they were good. Got the lead and then it was all hands to the pump. Fantastic performances, Declan Rice, you know, Dawson's, Diop, you know, brilliant defending there, Soufal, you know, excellent.
How big a win that for West Ham?
Oh, it's a massive win, not just because it's Spurs.
No.
But look, to see West Ham in that position, top four, is a fantastic achievement from David.
Yeah.
You know, considering the trials and tribulations of last year, but in the top four, great.
It's been 13 years since West Ham finished in the league table above Spurs. They're now 9 points above Jose Mourinho's side.
I feel sad, obviously. I feel that the result should be a different one from what we played, especially in the second half. So that's my feeling and a little bit of deja vu because the defensive line was brilliant. The centre backs they clean everything and they gave us a very difficult match for such a dominancy, especially in the second half, and we start the game with a defensive mistake and we start the second half with another one, and when you are punished by these goals, then is difficult. But the team, especially in the second half, was trying absolutely everything and had the chances and was not also lucky with hitting the post twice, but we had great crossing situations across the face of the goal. We had easy shooting positions to score with dead balls in the box or just outside the box. So we should score more goals in spite of the two goals that we conceded. Look, I've been speaking about this for such a long time. And it's not good to stay always on the same page. But I believe that every person that watched the game understood clearly the nature of the goals that we conceded, and then it's difficult against a team that fought in the second half. They didn't play, they fought, and this is not a critic, this is to praise their spirit. They fought hard, but they just fought, and we were the team that tried to play, create a lot of chances, and then the boys were not lucky because the result, I don't think we deserve that. I know it's quality. I cannot say everything to you. I shouldn't. I don't want. I believe that as a coach, I don't have to speak too much about the situation, but with the Gareth Bale completely fit and ready to play 90 minutes of every game, of course he would. So we are trying everything with him to recover him to be at a good level. But for example, to play 60, 65 minutes like he did Thursday today. He couldn't start the game. He wouldn't have 90 minutes to give us. So that's the situation. But happy because he brings us what we know he brings. He brings us quality and a very unlucky shot because in that situation we have a double shot to score and we didn't. Promise, before the game I was not looking to the table. I was looking to the game and the objective was to win, and when you win, you look to the table and you see where you are. You know, of course, it's very difficult to think about top four. The top four teams, top four, five, six, they're getting points. It's going to be very, very hard. The Europa League is a great motivation, not easy, but a great motivation because it can be a way to get a Champions League spot and at the same time a trophy. So I think, like the boys showed in the second half to everyone that could see it, they fight. And when the team fights, you have also to believe that good things can come.
Great performance. I might not agree with you on that, Laura, completely, but that's me being having my negative head. But all the other aspects, the players' character, their desire, their commitment, we had to play 5 minutes without a player. So all those things which you hope's there, and and if you can add your good football to it, then obviously you get really good performances. But a great win for us. It really was a tough opponent and a tough team we were playing against today. Our things like our possession, our retention of the ball, we feel as if we need to be better. But I keep saying, I think we're only growing, and I'm trying to get good foundations down that we can try and improve. And that's why I'm trying to say, well, let's not get carried away totally. We've still got a lot of things to do. But, sometimes in football, all the simple things like real desire and hunger to try and succeed covers up other things as well. I think it was, because I think Tottenham put us under pressure at different times, and especially late in the game. But we had another one or two chances we thought were self in the first half, and we didn't take care. And it's a bit what I was talking about, what can you improve on? Well, they're the things that I want to improve on, because I think maybe if we'd taken a bit more care, I think we'd have probably got ourselves 2-0 up at one point in the game, and we didn't quite do that.
Thomas Souček, you mentioned, went down with it.
Yeah, he's been great. And again, it's the sort of things, but if you're a manager, it's a manager's dream. You've got somebody who wants to play, really humble about being here, working here. So he's a great boy to have, and he's been a very good player for us as well. But today, to get a few stitches, sometimes it's not an easy thing to do and come back on. Yeah, it's. Jesse, I think, has been a very good player. I don't think we should take that away. I think he's maybe had a difficult year or so. But I hope that we can help him get better. But he's helping us as well, which is a big thing. He's come in. I think sometimes when you bring people in January, you're never sure what you're going to get from them. But Jesse's given us something else, helped us get better. We've got quite a lot of competition in those areas for places, which hope we can keep that going and they can keep producing. Yeah, good. But, I've told them we're only done half a job. I think, if we continue this way, well, we'll be close. So I don't want to be negative in any way. It's a great result for us to beat Spurs, with the ambitions that they've got and what they have at their disposal. So, no, we're enjoying it, but we're also not going to go daft. We'd be stupid to say anything, and we're going to keep calm about it, but hopefully keep pushing and pressurising the teams near the top. MD, who's been a West Ham supporter, and even, over the years when I've been playing against them, I think West Ham, there's always been bits where they've won some really big games, which has been great. But what we want here is consistency. And I think at the moment, we've had consistency, I think, since after lockdown. And for me, I think that's the biggest thing I'm trying to get at the club. Stability, consistency. Where we can... Well, we might not always be up near the top, and we might not even be there by the end of this season. But I think this club badly needs a level where they're not going to be bobbing round the bottom or think that they're going to get relegated. This time last year, you were asking me the questions about can you avoid relegation, so... It's a great feeling to know that that's gone, but it's an even better feeling to know that we're now challenging for other things. And it's like Nels is always a first for everything, isn't there? And Jose Mourinho's had great teams, whether it be Chelsea. He's been an incredible competitor. You only need to see the medals and the trophies he's won. He's just up there with the top there is. He's up there with all the elite managers. But football sometimes can get your results. We've got ours today.